I know I'm late, but I finally watched Gray Man. It might have been one of the better things Netflix has made recently. Here's the trailer if you haven't seen it.
The Gray Man.
He's so hot. He's so hot.
I got an urgent locate and destroy.
And they're both so hot. The man's got some street. Okay, I don't want to show any more. Actually, it's a great scene to pause on. I don't want to show you any more of the trailer. So first things first. Netflix doesn't have the best track record when it comes to movies. I think Jared is into men. I can appreciate if a man is attractive. Like, it's Ryan Gosling is super attractive. Either way, I give Netflix a lot of crap, right? They don't make good stuff that often. They make great animated series. They cut their animation department. They make like a good TV series. They give it one season. They make big deals with movie stars. Did we ever talk about Adam Sandler Netflix deal? Let's just look to see how much money they gave him. Oh, four movies for $275 million. I'm sorry. I cannot imagine the movies Adam Sandler makes drives that much. To be fair, they are a business. They probably know. They probably do their CBAs and they run their Excel spreadsheets, and I understand that. That's a lot of money, and I don't buy my Netflix subscription to see that. I don't normally look at Netflix as someone who makes great movies, right? And I think now they're really starting to see what competition is doing to their platform, right? Because we see HBO Max getting subscribers, Hulu's getting a ton of subscribers. Amazon is finally revamping their platform to build something that can compete with them. And Netflix is losing subscribers for the first time in like history. Truly. They are struggling. And it's, you know, maybe not super apparent to just someone who doesn't care. But you can look at their stock and you can look at their subscribers. They're struggling. So they have put out recently some actual good stuff. And I think one of them is The Gray Man. As it says here, CIA has a skilled operative who is The Gray Man. And they send out a psychopathic former colleague, puts out a bounty on his head, and they send out Chris Evans to go kill Ryan Gosling. It's low-key not that bad. I mean, it's really not that bad. One of the cons I would have to give it is definitely like a straight up just like action shooter generic film. Like, right, there's nothing special about it. Every single plot point, every single side quest you would imagine in an action adventure film, it's in here. If I'm being honest, that's something that I bother with, right? Like, action adventure is so generic. It's so overdone and there's not much variety in it. It's like why examples I liked Ambulance, because I thought it tried something different, albeit super generic. But they like put drones in their shot in their movie, like filming, and that's incredible to me. So I gotta give them credit, right? Like, I'm not gonna give them points for it. I'll give them one, but I wouldn't give them, you know, three. The budget's estimated $200 million. Damn, that is a lot of money. Pros, the movie is perfectly fine. Like, it's an action adventure movie, but it's done well for an action adventure movie. As you can see in these shots, these actually really aren't that played up for the trailer. Their action scenes are really well done. The movie's made by the Russo brothers, who, as you know, people won't recognize, as they did, you know, they did some of the best Marvel movies. They've got, I think they did Extraction as well. It's just, you know, making a really solid action adventure film is not easy. You've got two of the hottest men in Hollywood and one of the most attractive women in Hollywood. All three superstars right now. I mean, Ana de Armas is about to be in that Marilyn Monroe biopic, which will be a day one watch for me. I will stay up till midnight to watch that movie. Extraction felt like a benchmark film to me. Exactly. And that's exactly what this is, Sham. It's an enjoyable film. I'm not going to lie, I actually had more fun watching this movie than I anticipated. Like, it's not bad. It's average. Cons are, it's average. There's also felt like there was some unresolved conversations. I hesitate to say plot lines. Because they were very small. I wanted some resolution to them. But the pros, it's well done for what it is. I respect the Russo brothers and their craft. They did it well. The action scenes were good. This one right here is one of the more egregious ones. Again, how am I going to complain? I felt like they could have spent less, right? They want to save money. It did good. You know, it was number one trending on Netflix for a while, right? For like a couple weeks. Pros, there's the actors and actresses. It's averagely well done. I hate saying that's a pro, but, you know. Unique-ish plot line, right? I mean, while it's an action adventure, it was different, albeit definitely done before, but different. I mean, there's really not too much to say about the movie. It's straightforward. I mean, would I recommend it? If you're bored, this is something you could put on in the background, right? Like, I was doing stuff while watching this, folding laundry and stuff like that. It was perfectly fine. It feels like the quintessential, like, Netflix movie, right? Like, movie. Netflix does great other things. You know, they have this new Untold series that they're doing. Are incredible, by the way, if you haven't seen it. This movie is something you would be disappointed to see in the theaters, but okay with seeing at home. I, as a self-proclaimed movie critic, I'd give this like a 6. I'd give this a 5.5 or a 6. Nothing is done extremely well. Everything's done at average or a little above average. The big ones for me are really, you know, acting. You have some of the best in Hollywood, and they can continuously prove it even with possibly a subpar script. So we gotta give them credit there. Personally, 6.5. I actually think the IMDb score is kind of right on the spot here. I enjoyed it enough to give it a 6.5. A 7 is really punching. I mean, it's no way it makes it up there. But what can you ask for? It's an average action adventure film. They're not gonna, you know, ball out. I mean, they're gonna ball out with the price tag, $200 million. I bet you 3/4 of that went to the damn three main actors. Overall, like I said, don't go out of your way to watch it. Watch it if you like movies, and you're bored.